8 plus negative 12.
Okay, that's the right size of the equation we added together.
Yeah, so negative 4.
All right.
And then y plus, negative y plus y is 0, so okay. You cancel each other out.
Cool.
And then be 4x. And then you take, divide by 4 from each side.
All right, take it even farther, that's good.
And then you get negative 1.
Let's stop there. Let's stop right there. And good. That is exactly what I meant by adding two equations together. Okay. We're almost done. You want to take the variant quiz?
And then y will equal 0.
Y will equal 0?
Yeah.
How do we know that?
Well, because it can't. Well, y can be anything else, see?
No, oh, because it got eliminated.
Yeah.
But no, that's not what that means.
I don't know.
I see what you're kind of thinking back to when you have variables on both sides, they get canceled out, like this.
Yeah.
But, see, the difference is here we have two equations going together. That's how we got eliminated. It's not one equation. So, actually, y does have a specific value that it can be. You think it's 0? Mm-hmm. Why do you think that?
As it cancels each other out.
I see why you keep that. It's like the same process to find y as we've ever done.
You could plug in x.
Right, that's exactly what we're doing. And it doesn't matter which equation that we use. Negative 3 times negative 1, I'm just using this top equation here. Minus y equals 8. Okay. We need to ask an important question, and then we need to answer that important question. Should be the other equation, that's all right. Negative y equals 5, so y equals
negative
5. So negative 1, negative 5. Well, that's pretty simple, right? That's pretty straightforward, pretty easy, and that's pretty cool. A lot of students really like this method. It's called the elimination method because
they
eliminated the y in that case. You can eliminate x's for a different set of equations. But here's an important question that the answer to this may not stick with you forever, but we've got to ask and answer this question. That's real nice and everything, and it's really handy and fast, but can we even do that? I mean, I told you to do it. It doesn't mean that you can do it. We have to justify that it's something we can do. I just took an equation and added to another equation. That kind of seems like magic. Okay. So let's just use these two guys here as kind of proof that we can do something like that. All right. Here I have two equations. You guys agree with that? This is an equation, that's an equation?
Yeah.
Just like I have two equations there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Here. We took the lavender, right, left side, and the green left side, and we added them together. We just combined the light terms, and on the right side, we added the numbers together. We need to make sure that we can do that. When we're working with equations, what's the cardinal rule? Whenever you work with an equation,
do the same to one side as you would to the other side.
Right. So think about that. Like on the left side of this equation, I'm essentially adding 7x plus y, and on the other side, I'm adding negative 12. Are they the same thing? They're not exactly the same thing. I mean, they're not both negative 12, and they're not both 7x plus y. I'm not adding 7x plus y on this side and 7x plus y on this side. And I'm not adding negative 12 on this side and negative 12 on this side. I'm adding two different looking things. But that's okay. Let's use this as an example. So here's an equation. Let's call that an equation. And here's another equation. How do I know they're equations?
They're balanced.
Yeah, they're flat like that. And that's how that works. So let's look at this head. The stuff on this side and the stuff on this side. Are they the same thing?
Yeah.
In case you can't see it, I'll just like this mark. And I'll just pay attention to that question. Is this the same thing as this thing?
Yes.
No, but that has the same value.
As the same, yeah, the same value, the same weight. But they look different. Right? But they're equal to each other. Okay? So I don't really know what's in here, I don't know what's in here, but I do know that together they're equal to this. They're not the same, but they are equivalent. The weight of them is equivalent. Okay. So if I take this stuff and this stuff, all right, what do you know about these two cups here?
Same weight.
The same amount. So if I put this stuff over here, if I can even manage to do that. other side, what's going to happen?
It'll be equal.
It'll stay equal just like it started. So even though the stuff that I put put on this left side and the stuff I put on the right side didn't look the same, they were equivalent to each other. They weighed the same amount. And the same reasoning holds here. The stuff that I added on the left side is equal to the stuff I added on the right side. And so I've done the same thing to both sides, essentially. Clint?
Can I use this on the test to finish stuff?
What?
This theory?
Oh, yeah. Unless I say use substitution specifically.
Okay.
Yeah, so this is called elimination. So if I said solve the system of equations using elimination, that's what you would do. You would eliminate it. Okay, well, let's do another couple where it's just all set up, ready to go. If you add two equations together, something's going to get eliminated, and you take it from there. See if you really get it. Maybe you followed what I was doing, but well, let's see if you really, really get it. Okay. Here we go, a couple of equations. If you add them together, I think you can see generally what's going to happen. Let's see if you can take it all the way through and find the solution, okay? All right, so we're going to add the two equations together. A little discussion over there with the scales proves we totally do that. So someone give me the left side of this new equation that we would add them together. Yeah?
Oh, you mean like the answer or?
Just the left side of when I add these together, like what do
oh,
I get?
Okay. Negative 7x equals 7.
Okay, and you leave it on the right side as well. That's fine. Everybody see what happened there? We got the 5x, or the 5y, minus 5y is 0y. And negative 4x minus 3x is negative 7x. And solving this becomes very simple. We divide by negative 1, or sorry, negative 7, and we get negative 1. And then plug it into here or here. Or both, but I mean, doing it into both would really just be a good test to make sure that we did the first part right, because we should get the same y either way, right? So I'll go ahead and do both side by side. So negative 3 times x, which we know now is negative 1, minus 5 times y equals negative 7. If I were to do that in the other equation, it would look like negative 4 times negative 1 plus 5y equals 14. So when I do both of these, I should get the same y twice. So negative 3 times negative 1 is positive 3 minus 5y equals negative 7. Subtract 3 from both sides. Negative 5y equals negative 10. Divide by negative 5 on both sides. Y is 2. I should get y is 2 here as well. Negative 4 times negative 1 is 4. Plus 5y equals 14. Subtract 4 from both sides. 5y equals 10. Divide by 5 on both sides, y equals 2. So confirmation, we must have done that first part, right?
Okay, I was confused. When you said apply it to 1, I thought you meant like, I don't know, I was just like really confused. So I was stuck like, what?
So now you're less confused.
I thought we were supposed to do it to the y too.
Oh. I'm supposed to put negative 1 in there for y as well?
Yeah.
Okay. But yeah, we're trying to figure out y in that second part. And it, you know, you don't need this much. When you get done, you shouldn't have this much work written down. Probably just like that and this, or that and this. Okay. It's a nice, pretty neat little trick that I imagine whoever came up with this first was pretty proud of themselves. Like they were pretty clever, and they were pretty clever. So negative 1, comma 2, solution to the system. It's the x and y, the only x and y that works in both of these equations. One more where it's just perfect. It's just set up. That if you just get it, add the two sides together, something's going to cancel out. And then, you know, we'll add a little bit of a challenge to it. Okay, so we add these together. Let's try that again. 3x plus negative 3x is no x. That's why it's called the elimination method. The x has got eliminated. Negative y plus 7y is?
Negative 6y.
Oh, positive 6y.
No, whatever.
Same. Or whatever. 30 plus 6. It's 36. Divide by 6.
6.
Y is 6. Then you plug it in into either one, it doesn't matter. So I'll use the top one because I know I'm solving for x and that's positive and I like that to be positive. Minus 6 is 30, 3x. I add 6 to both sides. 3x equals 36 and x equals 12. 12, 6.
On our work, do we have to show that we divided by 6 or if we just put y equals 6 underneath?
I think we're to a level now. We all know we're dividing by 6 on both sides.
Okay.
The most useful thing, the most useful thing is that it helps you to go back and find mistakes if you do happen to make a mistake. And on a test, it helps me find your mistake and give you more likely more partial credit. Any questions? We've done 3 examples where it's just ideal. Like when we add it together, we know that something's going to cancel out. And in the next example, it's not going to be ideal. So are there any questions before we move on?
So it doesn't matter which, if you cross out x or y first. So if you did, or if you subtracted or added the equation, does it matter?
Well, yeah, it does matter. If I were to subtract this equation, it would actually mean that subtract a negative 3x would be add a 3x, and I'd get 6x.
Okay. So do you add every single equation?
We're going to be adding every equation. Like the book, I think, actually is going to maybe frame it as subtract the equations.
Okay.
I don't think that. I think long term, the best idea is to think of it as adding, right?
Okay.
And we just want to make sure that we add opposites so they eliminate each other. That's gonna be our goal. We're gonna make sure that either the x's are opposite each other, so when we add, they eliminate, or the y's are opposite each other, so when we add, they eliminate each other. So let's take a look at this system. Are these x's gonna eliminate each other?
No.
What are we gonna get?
14x.
I would like one of those x's to be what?
Negative.
Like that. Okay. We're gonna make that happen. But we have to be mathematical about it. We can't just throw things around the way we want them to, just because we want them to. How could I possibly get this to be a negative 7x? Aiden? Good. Following the cardinal rule of working with equations, do the same thing with both sides. Okay? So if I multiply this side by negative 1, right, distributing it to everything on the side, and this side by negative 1, then I'll get that opposite 7x like I wanted. I'll just bring this guy over exactly the way it looks. 7x minus 2y equals 5. And now we're changing the look of the second equation. It's still the same equation, still has the same solutions. We're just changing the look of it so it works for us. Negative 7x. What's next?
Plus 3y.
Plus 3y. What's next?
Equals negative 4.
Exactly. And now, if you didn't, you know, if on that last example you feel like you didn't quite get all the way there by yourself, here's enough. Now it's set up. Now when we add them together, the x's will cancel each other out. So get it a little more practice and give that a try. All right, you guys are getting better and faster at this, so I'm going to go ahead and bring your attention up here. So the 7x plus a negative 7x is going to be 0x. Negative 2y plus 3y is just a positive 1y. 5 minus 4 is 1. And that couldn't have been easier, right? Y is 1. And now when we plug 1 in for y, it could go here, it could go here, there. Of course, that's the same thing as that one. It could go there, it could go in the original equation if we want. It does not matter. Everything, it's all going to give us the same x. So let's plug into that original one just to confirm that that's true. That's not the one I'm substituting. 3 times 1 equals 4. So I'm going to add 3 to both sides. 7x equals 7x equals 1. 1, 1 is our solution.
That's what I got.
All right. So we're going to do this again. It's going to be, you know, elimination is our goal, but we're going to have to help the system of equations along a little bit so that elimination will happen. That's not good. So if we add these together, how many x's will I get?
12.
12, yeah. See,
okay,
6x.
Reverse, huh?
Yeah, that's what we're going to do.
Reverse what?
Or put 6x where y is and then y for 6x.
Yeah, that's true.
These two here?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I can rearrange it, but here's how it's going to look. So the top one will look like this, negative 8y. But let me try and keep this color coded. I want to show everybody that that's going to be necessary to multiply by negative 1. Because if I rewrite this, if I just carry this equation over, negative 8y plus 6x equals 36, if all I do is switch where these guys are, that doesn't change the sign. Right? So I get negative y plus 6x still equals 15.
But I could see that like being easier, though.
Yeah,
same. And, you know, if you like the x's and y's to line up, then certainly do that. Right? But don't think that you have to. It's not a necessity. But if you like to line them up like that, go for it.
So we have to do plus right here. We have plus everything.
Do you want us
right?
To times by negative 1?
Well, we just got to do whatever it takes to get things to eliminate, and we're going to need to multiply by negative 1 in order to make it happen. Because if we don't multiply by negative 1, let's see what happens. We get negative 9y plus what?
12x
equals
51.
Yeah, 51. If you add two equations together and neither x or y get canceled, you should just erase what you did and try again. Because the purpose of adding these equations together is to get something to eliminate. But I'm just going to back up and say, what happened? What went wrong there? How do I get it to actually cancel out? Flint?
Oh, well, what if the x is on the 7x and you have 3x? What happens?
Oh, we're going to address that here in the couple examples from now. Actually, maybe in the next example. So how will I get it so that the x's will cancel out? Times by negative 1. Either of the equations, doesn't matter. So multiply all the way through this equation, both sides of it, by negative 1.
Oh, I accidentally did it to both.
Ah, yes. So you'll have the exact same problem.
Yeah,
except for you'll get negative 12. So negative 8y, right? I'm just rewriting the first equation exactly as it looks, and then I'm going to multiply the second one by negative 1. So you get a positive y minus 6x equals negative 15. And now the dream's about to come true. Y minus 8y is negative 7y. 6x minus 6x is 0. And 36 minus 15 is 21. So y is negative 3. Now we know y is negative 3. I'm going to plug that into this original equation here. 6x minus negative 3 equals 15. 6x plus 3 equals 15. 6x equals 12. X equals
3.
2.
What?
Divide by 6 on both sides, you get
2. Oh, I got something else.
So, next, Clint had an excellent question. What if, you have a 7x and a 2x? How are you going to get those to cancel out? We're going to have a much simpler question than that. But it's just a little bit more complicated than multiply one of them by negative 1. But only slightly more complicated. So, it's not like just multiplying one of these equations by a negative 1 is going to make the x's or y's opposite and make it so that they cancel when we add them. We're kind of close.
Yeah. Can you just like multiply one side by equal multiply both the top one by two, and you could do the bottom one. I don't know.
No, just
so
the
they
top
have to
one
be the same?
Huh? Yeah.
Can't
do it. Never mind.
You could do the top
can,
one
yeah,
by
you
three,
one
and
one.
The bottom one by five.
Well, you could, but what if we just did what
yeah,
you said originally? What if we did this by two? It doesn't matter what it eliminates, X or Y, it doesn't make a difference.
Oh, I see.
So what do we get when we multiply this by 2? We get, what?
10x plus 4y.
10x plus 4y.
Equals maybe 32.
Yeah. 10x plus 4y. And this other equation, black, 3x minus 4y equals 20.
So that cancels that one out.
Right. When we add it together, what cancels out?
Y.
So we get 10x plus 3x.
And 13x.
52.
Should be equal 3, I think. 4.
4.
4. Yeah. 4.
Basically.
Okay, great. Turn those off. X equals 4. And so what do we do now?
Now we plug in X.
Plug it in for X and find Y. I'll use this original equation here. 5X plus 2X. 5 times X plus 2Y equals 16. That's 20. I'm going to subtract 20 from both sides and get negative 4. Y equals negative 2. Or negative 2.
Well, how do you do that?
Well,
oh,
skip the couple steps.
Oh, yeah, I see.
That's
what
20
you,
subtract
yeah,
20.
I see what you're doing. All right. I see you.
What do you guys think about that?
Why did we do a different number this time?
A different number?
Besides negative 1 to multiply.
Well, because our ultimate goal here is to get something to cancel out, get something to be eliminated.
Right.
We do that by getting either the x terms in both the equations or the y terms in both the equations to be opposite.
Okay.
And one way, among infinitely many ways to do that, is to multiply the first equation by 2 so that we get a positive 4y and a negative 4y.
Oh, so we just have to try to make one of those match so that they would both eliminate.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
There's infinite ways to do it.
Yeah, to get infinite ways, we kind of have to do silly things. Like, I can multiply this one by 4 and this one by 2, and that would give me 8 and negative 8. We kind of.
Because you can get over the bigger.
Yeah.
That'd be dumb.
Yeah, it's a little dumb. And then we could do the same thing, like you said, we're going to multiply this by 3 and this by 5. Except for one of those would have to come out negative, so I'd have to choose one of them would be negative. But this is a perfectly good way, as are all the other ways. Okay. So, let's try another. So we look at those two equations. It's a little bit of a challenge. It's almost like a not too difficult a puzzle. What am I going to do to one of these equations so I can get them to match up so that they'll eliminate? What do you say, Kyle?
Well, on the bottom one, you could multiply it by negative 5, and then on the top one, you could multiply it by 3.
Okay.
I don't have to. Can you just multiply one of them?
You can just do 3.
Yep.
Yeah,
you can
just
do
negative
3.
You could just do negative 3. That would give us a 6 and a negative 6. But will this work?
Yeah.
Well, so let's just do it this way, just to prove that we can do it. So this one becomes what? Yeah.
That equals 18x
plus 15y equals some sort of 46.
47.
No. 47. 47.
No, I'm just going to do it.
47.
Yeah. No, that would be 57. 57. Be 57.
That's 57.
57.
Negative 5 times 2x. Negative 10x,
negative
5 times 3y, negative 15y, negative 5 times 5, negative 25. If you're choosing to instead multiply the bottom equation by negative 3,
don't
go for it. More power to you. I'm just doing it like this on the board. It doesn't matter what we get to eliminate, as long as something eliminates when we add these equations together. 18x minus 10x is 8x. Y's get eliminated. 57 minus 25 is 32, and x is 4. X is 4, so how about this? 2 times 4 plus 3y equals 5.
4 negative 1.
Plus 3y equals 5. Minus 8, we get 3y equals negative 3. Y equals negative 1. 4, negative 1.
Could it be any number you put in there?
What do you mean any number?
Could it be any number?
In which step are you talking about? Here or here?
Here.
Here?
No.
Here.
Right.
Yeah, we can choose to multiply by anything we want. Our goal, though, is something's going to eliminate. If nothing eliminates, then that was kind of a wasted trip. We want to choose something to multiply by something either in one equation or both equations. Actually, Kyle is kind of tapping into the next little challenge where we actually have to multiply both equations by something. In this case, what I would do personally, after lots of experience, I would have just multiplied the second one by negative 3, gotten 6x and negative 6x, and you know whatever else happens, happens, and gone about that way. But either way you go, you still will get 4 negative 1. Okay.
And after...
Are we getting a worksheet on this?
No, we'll get bookwork.
We get a whole account.
We're not done yet with you.
Oh, we have to learn from this.
Alright. What do you guys think? What can we do to this system to get something to cancel?
5.
4 on the bottom.
4 on the bottom.
And
3
on the top.
3 on the top?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sounds good, right? Because we will wind up with a positive and a negative. That's what we want. So 4, positive 4, positive 3. I bet that's going to work out just dandy. Okay, so 3 times 4 is 12x. 3 times 5y is
21.
3 times 35 is?
40. No.
No.
105.
Next, in the second equation, you're going to wind up with negative 12x, which is exactly what we want. 4 times 2, that's 8y. 4 times negative 9, negative 36. 0. X 15y plus 8y is 23y. 105 minus 36.
69.
Divide by 23.
3.
Y is 3. And I'm going to use the first equation. 4x plus 5 times 3 equals 15. No, 35, not 15. 4x plus 15 equals 35. Subtract 15, we get 20. X equals 5. 5.